There's actually a study that was done about younger men recently where they found that the men under the, I think it's under the age of 35 or something, are actually having, are hooking up, are having sex way less than ever before. They found that, I think it was around like, oh, it was 26%. 26% of men, which is the highest number ever recorded in history, of men are haven't had sex, have been celibate for over a year, right? And that number increased. I think it used to be like 14% or something like that. The number for women also increased. It went from around 14 to, I think it was like 18 or something like that. But for men, if you meet men, one in four of them haven't hooked up in a year, right? And so, you know, you think, oh, guys are just like, it's so easy for guys to go out there and hook up nowadays. It's not easier for all guys. It's easier for players. It's easier for narcissists. It's easier for guys that are constantly going out and are really good at playing with women's emotions. It's easier for those guys because it's easier for guys that are like really incredibly good looking. When I used to be in the men's dating industry, I think this is kind of interesting. And we did a study at one point. It wasn't really a study. It was more like a just a game. We took a like a really, really good-looking man's picture, and we created a Tinder account for him. And we had two accounts, right? Like a regular guy and a guy that was like ridiculously good-looking. And we did a bunch of swiping with both of them. And we took the guy that was really good-looking, and we had him messaging all these women. And what ended up happening was when you're the guy that's really good looking on Tinder, you can basically say anything. The guys that were like actually doing the messaging for this, they would say just crazy stuff. Just like they'd like make fun of the girl. They'd like, you know, just say something that's really like kind of weak and pathetic and just act super like needy and desperate and stuff. And the women were just all over it. And then you notice with the guy that was just average looking, it was like he had really hard time even kind of getting to the space where the girl was even interested in going on a date with him at all, right? Because what's ended up happening, especially with these dating apps, is that it's not easier for all guys now to meet and hook up. It's easier for guys that are really good looking to hook up and guys that are really good at talking to women. Those guys are hooking up with lots and lots and lots of women, lots of them, right? And the guys that are more normal, more average, are it's actually harder for them to meet and hook up with women now because the look standard is so much higher, right? And a lot of women are raising their standards for who they want to hook up with, but it's not like, is this a good guy? The standard that they're raising is does he make me laugh? Does he make me feel good inside? Am I attracted to him, right? Which is normal, right? That's what we think, right? When we go on a date, it's like, am I attracted to this person? Do I feel good about this person, right? They don't think, is he a good guy? Because if he's a good guy, that's fine, but it doesn't matter if he can't make you feel really good. If he can't go on a date with you and be entertaining and make you feel good about yourself and say the right things and not come off creepy or like he's too much, but also not be too distant and, you know, have a conversation with you. Like, women value communication really, really highly, right? In the way that they interact with a guy, right? It's not, is he a good guy? Okay, I'm interested in him. It's, does he make me feel butterflies? Do I feel really good around him? Do I feel comfortable? Am I excited about him? Like, is he saying the right things, right? And that's what makes a woman want to hook up with a guy, is she feels excitement, she feels comfort, and then she feels this physical draw to him. And if he plays his cards right, which guys that play their cards right are usually players and narcissists and guys that are really good at messing with your emotions, most good guys are not like that at all. They don't know how to do that. They have no idea how to play with your emotions and make you feel good. And so a lot of really good guys are not getting laid right now. They're not hooking up. They're not a part of the hookup culture because they're spending their time doing other things. They're working their jobs. They're living their lives. They're not running around hooking up with girls. And so they don't understand how it works. And that's when they end up coming over to the men's dating side and learning about it. And, you know, for men, one of the things I talk about to a lot of women about the men's dating journey is that a lot of times it's a really long journey, right? It's not like when you come to the women's side, we're like, oh, here's what you do, right? You stop chasing him, you lean back, you have fun, you know, get playful, right? For on the men's dating side, it's like, okay, you need to go and like develop your personality. You need to go get and learn about your passions and get an awesome job and like start figuring out your life and like, you know, go and like, you know, sometimes they'll recommend taking acting classes and stuff and improv classes just to like get them out of their bodies and get them into their emotions, and they learn how to talk and just sometimes they'll send them to like comedy courses and stuff like that. Like that's what men do who are trying to become more attractive to women, is that they go through this huge journey of developing their personalities and becoming stronger, better men, developing their, getting into their masculinity and learning how to become a leader and, you know, all this kind of stuff. And not to say that, you know, women aren't doing a lot of work for themselves in this space, right? Like we all have like issues and we all have problems and stuff, but it's hard for everybody. Like that's really what it boils down to, is that there's a very small number of players at the top and they're hooking up with massive amounts of women, right? And women, their challenge is that there's this hookup culture and there's all these players, and these players are really good at making you feel really good, and you have to distinguish whether this guy's a player, whether he's a good guy, whether he's been developing himself as a man and now he's finally gotten to this space where he's a man, but he's looking for something real. Does he want something real with you and not just saying, hey, I want something real, which most guys want something real, but does he want... are you that potential real that he's looking for, right? And so it's a jungle out there for most people. And I totally went off on a tangent there, but I just wanted to talk about that a little bit, because it's, you know, a lot of women are like, oh, it's so easy for guys to go run out there and hook up. And it's not. It's not easy for most guys to go out there and hook up. For most guys, they aren't running around hooking up. Like most guys are like, I just want a girl that'll be my girlfriend. We can get into a relationship. I hope to God she's amazing. That way I don't have to go out and meet any other women ever again, because it sucks. It takes tons of time. You know, if you're going out as a guy and meeting women, you know, you might go and meet 100 women, and out of that 100 women, one of them will be your girlfriend, right? And that's like the odds for the average dude who's never like learned about dating advice or any of that kind of stuff before, who's not a player, any of that kind of stuff. He has to go and approach somewhere between like maybe 80 and 100 women in order to get to a girl that wants to be his girlfriend, right? Or who has the potential of becoming his girlfriend. Right? Because with women, it's like when you go out and you talk to a guy, if you say something stupid, he's going to be like, okay, well, I don't think that she's relationship material anymore, but we can hook up, right? As a guy, if I come out to a girl and I start talking to her and I say something stupid, she's like, I'm shutting him down altogether, you know, and go off somewhere else and find somebody else, right? And so it's just, you know, it's a different dynamic depending on which side you're on. And it's difficult for both sides because there's so many challenges and difficulties out there on both sides. And the hookup culture and these apps have just amplified all of those challenges. I think over time, it's going to end up evening out and we're going to end up figuring it out. But I think it's going to take some time and we're just clearly not there yet. Okay.